Sunday afternoon, and a testing of two different classes, LMP2 and LMP3, for a Friday event, 4 hours of Portimao. In those two classes, they gave us a free choice between LMP2 and LMP3, and I want to actually compare those two. I don't know the track, never driven in Portugal, and I will take LMP2 first. I will see how it drives. I won't be tuning it. It will be a standard tune, just to give it a try, just to see how quick it is, and then I will take LMP3. I will do a few more laps. I think LMP3 will have an advantage because we will be after LMP2 session. We'll know the track better. We'll know the braking points, acceleration points. We'll know the turns, hopefully. So let's give it a try. I don't have much time. It's a Sunday. It's a Formula One race in an hour. So let's use what we have.
Once you've got some temperature in the tyres and brakes, get a feel for the track and see what you think of the car setup.
As I said, I don't know the track, so I'm not sure where I'm driving. It will be a very slow first few laps just to learn the layout. I need to start my dashboard, just so I know the temperatures. Thank you. points and the proper speeds and gearing. It will take some time. I really don't know this truck. First time I saw it was this season in Formula 1 race, so I know nothing about it. These curbs are very slippery. Elevation changes do not help as well. A lot of blind corners. Ah, this corner. Still forgetting about it. We'll be right back. the blind right hander. A bit too slow. Still missed it completely. I think this is the first time I actually negotiated the turn semi-well. Far from perfect though. Okay, I'm far from knowing the truck or all its turns, but I ran out of fuel in this LMP2. I haven't done a single clean lap. But the times were around 39, the best was 38.7, some 40s. The longer I was in the truck, the better I was negotiating these turns, and the times were getting better and better. I will now swap to LMP3 and we'll do a comparison. I want to see it. Oh, United is here. Three cars racing. I think I'll take Oak Racing, maybe United. Again, default set, no changes whatsoever. Completely different sound of that engine. Bolt tires. Cold brakes. Take it slower to start with, just to get the feeling of the car. Oh. Forearm the tires a bit. fifth gear. I'm not saying it is, I haven't done a single lap within it, but it feels slower than LMP2. It should be slower based on the class. First lap, 1 minute 46.8, almost 7. Lacks the aero of LMP2, doesn't feel as stable. Actually, I have to fight it a bit more than LMP2, and I'm not even talking acceleration but braking. Stability under braking is very important. This car definitely has it, but less than LMP2. I still don't know the track, I'm forgetting about some corners, I'm missing the braking points, the times won't be perfect, but the LMP3 has an advantage because I only did 13 laps in LMP2. Yes, I'll be missing those, it doesn't matter really. Those curbs are very dangerous under the braking and under the acceleration. They destabilize the car really a lot, and it can finish with a spin or missing a braking point. going wide, losing time. Increasing the tire wear. This last turn is a good comparison of the LMP2 and LMP3. The LMP2 was much more stable in the last corner in comparison to LMP3. Too fast. Said earlier, this is just a comparison of LMP2 to LMP3 under the default setup. I'm still lacking the stability here. The rear tires are at a good working temp, the front tires, left one is, right one isn't, the brakes are too cold. First lap, which was an invalidated 1:43. That turn is definitely the hardest one. It takes some time to learn it. That would be 1:42.2 if it wasn't invalidated, and this one will be as well. 9 minutes 42.0. Okay, the Formula One race is coming soon, so that will be it for now. 1 minute 42.0 versus 1 minute 38.7, I think. 3 seconds and a bit, but I'm pretty sure that if I jump in LMP2 right now, I would improve that time of 1 minute 38.7. Just because I have a more experience on this track, I know it better, I know how to negotiate the turns better, and I know that one hard right-hander there, which was causing me a lot of trouble. Okay, I'll be back later, thank you very much for watching, and have a good Sunday all.